At around 2:30 in the afternoon, it's a quiet moment at Crook Street as the coal tank comes off shed for the next Manchester Exchange local, and in the yard, the Edge Hill goods is being prepared. At the coal hole, the Super D that will take the Edge Hill goods is turned in readiness for departure. At 2:40, Manchester sets off. It's the usual daily bread and butter work for the shunters. Assembling the departure wagons, allocating the inward wagons for Deansgate and the other local yards and sidings. And the Edgehill goods is ready to depart. The Super D's driver slowly takes up the slack in the couplings prior to accelerating his train. You don't want to spill the guard's tea. Thank you. Soon after, the 3:11 Manchester via Atherton and Tyldesley arrives. Meanwhile, in the steam shed, the waiting cauliflower sets off in preparation to take the Walkden sidings empties that are being prepared in the yard. The Ramsbottom 040 saddle tank is taking advantage of the lull on the main lines to slip off to the coal hole. Cauliflower sets off to Walkton with its load of empties. It'll call in at Lever Street and Flood a Lane as required to pick up any further empties on the way. The Bobby sets the road for the Row Green Junction route for the return working of the Atherton train to Manchester Exchange. Following shortly, the next Down Kenyon Junction motor train draws into Crook Street.